Shit. Fuck me. Fuck shit. Okay. Are you kidding? Oh, God damn it. I don't like this. No, what? What? What the fuck? I can't move. I didn't, like, stop holding my breath. Was that intentional? Was that supposed to happen? I didn't do anything wrong. So I don't understand why it all of a sudden just caught me. So I collect them all, scavenge from all the pain in the world. I don't understand what I did wrong there. It seems like that was supposed to happen. During the restless nights, their voices linger. An indistinguishable song of laughter and weeping. No, it just brought me back to the save point. That's really annoying and I don't like that at all. That's stupid. Alright, see you guys in a second. Oh, I have my inventory. Oh, I'm good. Can I go upstairs? Oh, well, great news. There's one in here too, so that's fantastic. Well, whatever. Anyway. What's in the desk? Only a single desk and a chair sitting in the middle of the class. It evokes a sense of solitude. There are some engraved marks on the table. They seem to be words and symbols, but they're too faint to read right now. This makes no sense at all, but fuck it. Why not? No, okay. I didn't think so. I guess we come back to this at some point. I'll try to remember. Alright. Get ready to hold your breath. Fuck. Great. Alright, get back in there. I'm pretty sure there's nothing else I'm able to do. No, that's not what I meant. Oops. Alright, I don't know if thing I can use the fence pliers on is up on that floor. It probably is, but I don't want to take the risk. Let me cut this. All right, good. Perfect. All right. Okay. We're good. We're good. All right, let's take a look at this note. Illustration food offerings. Picked up off the health center corridor. Put down the offerings and revere the lingered. Then hold your breath and do not linger. So basically just a suggestion should you not remember to hold your breath, essentially. What's this? Well, I know what this is, but whatever. Anyway. Snellen chart? I've never heard that term for it, but yeah. Snellen chart for an eye examination. The light box can be lit, if I remember correctly. Also, it looks like... Yeah, there we go. Probably a part of another puzzle or something. A food offering. Right, and that can get them to fuck off then. I'm guessing. Several documents on the desk. Patient records. Diagnostic reports from the health center. How can students be injured so severely like this? April 20th. Huang Mingchung. Age 17, male. Conditions, right arm comminuted fracture, left wrist bone fracture. Ugh. A whole bunch of, that's like a fracture where like a whole bunch of like bone spurs occur or something like that. That's definitely not pleasant. I don't understand the purpose of this. I don't know, fuck it. Let's just see. No? No? Provide the examination a food offering. That makes sense. Let's go ahead and save our progress real quick. Why not? Of course it's locked. Why would it not be locked? That's just silly. Storage room for medical supplies. It's locked. The nurse should have the key. The nurse. Oh, there it is. There's a shadow in the corner. Pull the board up. Yeah. Got it. Medical supply storage key. Well, there we go. Problem solved. Anyway, let's go ahead and save real quick, just because we made progress, thus we need to save it. Great. Okay, there we go. Perfect. Let's get out of here. Yes. All right, what's this? Emergency showers and eye wash station. Something in the water bowl. Another dye. So we have two now. Oh, there's blood on the floor. The floor is wet, but not with water, it seems. Okay. What about this? Sharp smell coming from the metal box. Paint thinner. Okay. Is that it? Looks like it. Okay, cool. Let's keep going. By the way, that flame has been going on for a while. Oh. Hmm. Well, we got another food offering, so that's nice. I was thinking there might have been something else. That's too bad. Or, like, I was figuring we were gonna go somewhere else, I should say. Alright, whatever. Hopefully that, creature's still enjoying their food offering. Nope. But that's okay. We're just wanting to go this way. Okay, so we've got to use the paint thinner for something. I can't remember a door that required paint thinner, though. Wait, did I just go upstairs? For this, maybe? Doesn't do anything. Well, that's too bad. I think I've already been in here. Yeah, this is the one with, like, the single desk. Alright, well, we need to go downstairs, which was my initial intent. Let's do it again. Shit! I can't remember. Shit. Okay. I didn't realize she was right behind me. I'm really struggling to think of where the paint thinner is applicable. Oh. What's this? Mr. Cow's room, what's on the door? Seems to have a bunch of talismans. Strange, it's not locked, but I can't open it. That's what you use the paint thinner for. You should be able to remove the talisman drawing. Yep. Perfect. Found the solution to this problem before even knowing the problem. Okay, what's this? This is a creepy room. I don't like this. Why is there a knife stabbed in the table? Despite the rust, it still looks sharp. Oh, it's a box cutter. I guess you... Yeah, whatever. Shit. Free calendar handed out by the township office. Every household has one. Poster of a famous celebrity. What's this? Just a bowl. Chipped white ceramic bowl. Can't lift it up, somehow it's stuck to the table. There are scratching marks inside the bowl. Guess the rumor of people gambling in school was not a rumor after all. Oh, so do we put the die in there? Should I throw the dice? I've seen people doing it. I think it requires 3 dice to play. Oh, okay. So we need another one to be able to make this work. So we'll come back to this. A water bucket. Something's in here. Another die? Oh, perfect. Well, there we go. Problem solved. That smell and the swarming bugs. Better stop looking at it or I might throw up. Okay, well, let's go ahead and take care of the bowl now. Yes. Ugh, what the fuck? 623. What's this? Pretty sure. Okay, these numbers. No way. I'm pretty sure those were dice when I threw them. Alright, good. Okay, I was hoping that we would take down something for it. What happened? After throwing the dice into the bowl, they turned into teeth. Are the numbers supposed to mean something? I would assume so. Oh. What's that sound? The bowl came loose. Alright, now we have a ceramic bowl for some reason. Huh. This is just a stab in the dark, but maybe, like, put the bowl on, like, that desk at the top floor? Maybe? I don't know. Ooh, there's a light. And I can't turn it on. Why would I? Note on the bench, illustration cutting throats. The prophecy is revealed when a sacrifice is made with the blood of an innocent. We have, I would assume to be an innocent right here, and we have a box cutter. So that should work. Yeah. There we go. Okay, let's do it. Ah, it's gross. Ah, okay. The blood's draining into the bowl. But it's full of dice teeth. Anyway. So we have a bowl of blood. What? His eyes just opened. That's not something that bodies are supposed to do. Alright, so we have a bowl of blood, and that's about it. We haven't really moved that much further in terms of progress, it doesn't seem like, but we have that. Ah, there we go. Alright, the blood sank into the marks. What can I use to print out the engravings? Okay, making a print with the notebook. Okay, that works. Cool. Oh, I'm pretty sure I cut this out, but I went downstairs as, like, just because I was looking around trying to figure out what to do, and I came across a a set of, or like a little lock that had a combination thing on it and had these sort of codes as like the thing that you were supposed to do to unlock it. But the thing is, I didn't really have the translation for it. So this obviously relates to, I believe it was 623 on the dice. So we do this one, and this one, I guess. All right, so separation on the bottom, or top and bottom. Separation at top, separation at middle. Okay. I should be able to remember that. All right, awesome. Jesus Christ, it's taken a while. Like, it's kind of an embarrassing amount of time, how long it's taken to be able to figure this whole thing out. But, through the power of editing, I can look like less of an idiot. So, I will most definitely use that as an opportunity. Alright. Alright. Okay, cool. So, I'm pretty sure it's the very end, if I remember properly. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So, it should be... No, damn it. Okay, I gotta go all the way around now. Son of a bitch. There we go. And a separation at the top. There we go. And then separation in the middle. Perfect. Click sound from the lock. And now we get to go upstairs on the other side. So it's like different and stuff. Oh. Shit. Gotta go up again to the third floor. Door's boarded up, can't get in. I would assume the same thing for that one. Oh, neat. What's in here? So we got a save station real quick. What else do we have? Oh, that's it. Okay. Well, that's fine. We'll just save real quick. And then we will enter through that last door. And see what's behind it. I don't like that. I don't like the glass. What's this? Oh, it doesn't say. I can't move. Oh, shit. Shit, 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 shitty shit. Okay, something's chasing me. Go faster. Fuck, he's gaining on me. Looks like he has like a police hat or something on. Fuck me! Oh god, oh, come on, Jesus Christ, how long is this fucking hallway? Oh god! Oh Jesus! Oh, that's certainly not unsettling. Amitabha Buddha? Amitabha, okay, whatever. Oh shit, what else did it say? Okay, well, I guess I'll never know, but you can go ahead and pause it if you wanted to read that last bit. I have a tendency to double-click, just, like, subconsciously, I do it all the time. Counseling record. Alright, piece of ripped counseling record, age 17, mother is a housewife, negative, troubled attitude, constant tardiness, gradually improving, require follow-up, encourage leisure activities such as reading. Signed by faculty members, counselor... that homeroom teacher, JROTC officer, principal. All right, I'm not gonna bother reading the names and making myself look stupid. What? Okay, so now we're at home. They say I should enjoy my youth, but I find it difficult. What happens after graduation? Where should I go? Will I end up like Mom? Stop worrying so much, Ray. Life moves on regardless. Be hopeful. That's right. You gotta force yourself to be optimistic and hopeful, because otherwise, bad things happen. At least this weekend's going to be... something. I don't know if that was supposed to continue. Whatever. Anyway. Someone clean the desk up for me. Probably Mom. I feel like there's no privacy in this house. My bed. I sleep much better on my own bed. It's quite foggy outside. I can barely see the roads. Dresser. Well-built closet. It was part of Mom's dowry. What? Mom's throwing my stuff without telling me. Old photograph in the trash. Quote is written on it. Remember, hope is a good thing. Maybe the best of things. And no good thing ever dies. That's not true. That's just not true. There's a lot of good things that die. I mean, there's a lot of good people that die. I mean, that's... most good things die, actually. No, excuse me. All good things die. Every good thing that has ever been, died. And every good thing that is, will die. That's kind of how things work. I mean, unless it's, like, non-perishable, I suppose. But I'm struggling to figure out a good thing that isn't perishable. Yeah, anyway, I'm not going to bother... you know, contemplating this for the rest of the playthrough, so we're just gonna continue. They're fighting again. Feeling a bit sleepy now, I should go back to bed. Alright, I'll do that. Yes. That's the point of going over to the bed, was to get in it. If a paper plane could whisk my dreams away from here, where I could wake up and find myself in a foreign land, to start a new life as a stranger to all. How wonderful that would be. Oh, we're back. Sounds like a flag is flying or something. That's right. Get up. Oh, that's odd. Our flagpole stand. The ropes keep knocking on the poles. Was there something we're supposed to do about that? I love how my body just illuminates everything now. Like I'm my own personal flashlight. Alright. What? The Japanese used this place as a barracks during their occupation. Doesn't seem like there's anything going on over there, so we're gonna go to the other side. The old brick building we used to call the Red House. The Japanese used... Oh, okay. Oh, alright, I didn't see that before. I could just walk in. Well, I'm dumb. Oh, okay. I was like, what the fuck is that? There's a note on the desk. Illustration, the Habai Wuchang. Black and white impermanence. According to legends, they are two ancient officials. During a routine inspection, misfortune befell them, and they perished trying to protect one another. The Lord of the Dead, seeing their loyalty, appointed them the duty of messengers of death. It was then that people who died would see them arrive to claim their souls. Well, that's creepy. Hey! Safe station. The entire screen seems to get, like, a little bit brighter every time I do that. Oh, hey. Two figures are carved onto the door. These are supposed to be the guardians, but they look more like the Habai Wuchang. Their hands look like they should be holding something. What could they be missing? Alright, so we need to put something in their hands. I got something to put in their hand. Yeah, anyway. I'm sure it's probably on the other side. Hmm. It's odd looking. Puppet theater on a hand-drawn cart. During summer break, the boys in class would use this as their battle tank. Unfortunately, they quickly broke the wheels, and there's a note on the cart. Lantern Spectre. An illustration of the Lantern Spectre. If you chance upon a lantern spirit, avert your gaze and stand unmoving. Okay, so I would turn around and just not move. I don't know if you can really successfully do both, but I will try. When it comes near, still your breath, do not panic, and it will keep on moving. So, look away, stay still, hold your breath if you come across something that looks like this vaguely. Good to know. I imagine I'm probably going to come across it pretty soon. Because it was pretty much automatic with the lingering or whatever. Glass beakers here from our biology lab. They're each holding puppets inside. Well, that's good to know they're just puppets. I was thinking they were something else. A large mass of puppets hanging from the ceiling. I don't like this. A brick furnace. I remember back then, Mom said she burned spirit money to bless her health and good fortune. I always thought of it as closer to dealing with the devil. Is that it? Alright, I don't think this is a good idea, but... Alright, what about... this is even worse, but let's just see. No, okay. It's worth a shot, it's always worth a shot. Well, let's keep looking around, I guess. Door's locked from the other side. Okay, awesome. Let's go downstairs. Good things always come from the depths. Like that, for example. That is certainly something that is good. Let's take a look at it. A kneeling figure with a wooden token on its back. Can't really tell who it is with a hood on its head. I remember like a hooded sort of character from the like very beginning of the game. Like they had that sort of montage at the very beginning right before, you know, Wei was, you know, hanging upside down and dead. Just before that, we had a brief cut to where there were like several like really weird images that didn't have any like seemingly particular meaning. But one of them was like a dude in like a sack over his head, and it was kind of like twitching, and it was just weird. Anyway, that just, I'm assuming that's kind of what that harkens back to. Wooden stocks and shackles, a bit of dried blood on the edges. I don't like this. Temple's divine incense burner. Before we pray, my mom always lights 3 incense sticks. She tells the gods her name and birthplace, then launches into a spiritual drivel. She often lays her many problems and wishes upon them. Why does she not tell a real problem? Instead, they fall upon an invisible god. Alright, so we gotta find 3 incense sticks, I guess. Ugh, I don't like that. I don't know. I don't know what that is. Like, I don't know why, but that little movement creeps me out. Cell's empty. Smells like rotting plants. Another kneeling figure. Who are they supposed to be? Ooh, we got something. That's blocked off. Spirit money. Right, and now we can throw that into the fire. Metal door, it's locked. Of course it is. Shit. I don't know what to do. I don't think that's what they are. Oh, okay. Yeah, cool. Totally. Yeah, I mean, right? It's no big deal. Fuck. I just want to get out of here. I don't like that creepy fucking dungeon. It scares me. All right, let's throw this thing into the fire. Because evidently that's what you're supposed to do with spirit money. And I don't like that noise that I just heard. That's not good either. Oh, otherworldly spirits, I offer the spirit money to ask for your protection. The fire went out, and it looks like we have a fan. The furnace has suddenly gone cold. Is something in there. How can this be? Should have been reduced to ashes if it was inside. Yeah, a feathered fan. Huh. Oh, what? Whoa, what? What? And I'm dead. Shit. Okay, so here we are. Am I good? Maybe. I'm not sure. I think I'm good. Alright. I'm out of the woods. For this particular section, at least. I think I'm fine. I shouldn't have said that. That was a very stupid thing to say. Big mistake. That's all right. Let's keep going. Now, I don't know if this fan is what I need. Well, let's go ahead and save real quick. Now, let's see if I can put the fan in their hand. No? Okay. Well, I don't think we ever tried this. No? Okay. So the fan doesn't fit in his hands, and the necklace does nothing. So we're still searching for a solution as to what could solve this problem. I'm guessing we need to go upstairs. Seems like the only course of action to take at this point. Goes up to the roof, but it's locked. Of course it is. Roots are growing out of the seams. The door is completely blocked. Yay! That's fantastic. It is very bright. There are various films on this rack. They seem to all be tangled together. That's actually very surprising. Like, how do you do that? How does one manage to tangle them all together? That's actually really impressive. The film in the media room is being projected from here. Our military education class often play political propaganda. The instructor always has a million things to say about whatever happens in the film. Are there any other films I can play? No, that's not what I want. So, I guess we're trying to find a film from an external source. So we gotta do something else in the hallway. I don't like that. That's not good. Alright, what's this? Oh, the incense! An unmarked grave embedded in the middle of the room. Shouldn't be anything buried underneath. There are three unlit incense sticks here. Yeah, of course take it. I need those. Oh, I think that might have been bad. Can I put them back? No? Shit. Well, they were kind of screaming, like, seemingly in pain at first. Then they were smiling. Maybe it's just different slides. Maybe that's all there is to it. Yeah, I don't know. My understanding is that, like, depending on the things you do in this game can change the outcome, like the ending. And for whatever reason, I feel like taking that incense may have just, caused some problems. Maybe I'm wrong. Okay, yeah, let's get out of the darkness. Let's not do that. Whoa, shit. Fuck. Okay. Jesus, that scared the fuck out of me. I think I got a little too hyped up for that. It wasn't that big of a deal. I just had to turn for a quick second, and I was fine. So, we're okay. But still, fuck me. That was, I don't know why, but that just really... Whew. Alright, anyway. Let's go ahead and burn this incense. I can't imagine there's anything else I can do other than burn the incense, right? That seems like the only, you know, course of action for this. Shit. Oh wait, I think it's back downstairs. Maybe I can put the incense in their hands? No? Alright. So, fun news, everyone. I gotta go back down to the creepy torture dungeon. Yeah, his footsteps echoed softly, invoking a sense of suspense. Reality faded away as time stood still. Ugh, I swallowed hard as the emptiness confined. Oh my god. Fucking what? I thought they were gonna have like some sort of tasteful way to apply this, but just no. Boom! You're fucking dead, kid.